Heavenly Father, our Creator, we offer this humble prayer in this Christmas season. We come to worship with a song of thanks in our hearts. As we prepare to celebrate the birth of your Son, we pray for joy in our hearts, hope in our God, love to forgive, and peace upon the earth. We ask for the salvation of our family members and friends. And we pray for your blessings on all people. May there be bread for the hungry, love for the unlovable, healing for the sick, protection for all children, and wisdom for the youth. We pray especially this year for an end to the pandemic. Lord, we surrender this terrible epidemic to you. Redeem the earth of this disease and let your children breathe freely in the new year. Holy Spirit, fill our hearts with your love and power. Mother Mary, intercede to your loving Son for us. In the name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen.
A reading from the book of Luke, chapter 1, verses 67-79. Zechariah, filled with the Holy Spirit, sang this canticle. Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel, for he has come and redeemed his people in the house of David, his servant. He has raised up for us a victorious Savior, as he promised through his prophets of old, salvation from our enemies and from the hand of our foes. He has shown mercy to our fathers and remembered his holy covenant, the oath he swore to Abraham, our father, to deliver us from the enemy, that we might serve him fearlessly as holy and righteous people. All the days of our lives, and you, my child, shall be called prophet of the Most High, for you shall go before the Lord to prepare the way for him, and to enable his people to know of their salvation when he comes to forgive their sins. This is the work of the mercy of our God, who comes from on high as a rising sun, shining on those who live in darkness and in the shadow of death, and guiding our feet into the way of peace. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. is finally here when we leave behind all our problems and just have fun.
Hi everyone. I am so glad to share a few thoughts with you on this occasion. Certainly the time of Christmas is one of great joy and celebration every year. And I am so glad that you are taking time to come together online and share in this wonderful season. My greetings go out to the principal, Dr. Sister Arpana, and the vice principal, Dr. Charmaine Jerome, and to all the staff and students of Mount Carmel College. From all of us here at Clarence High School, I want to wish you all a peaceful, safe, and joy-filled Christmas. Christmas of 2020 is vastly different, isn't it, from how we would have celebrated Christmas in 2019. I don't know if any one of us who are living today have ever experienced what we have gone through in these last few months, ever in our lives. In 2020, globally, about 1.6 million people and counting have died as casualties of an invisible enemy, the COVID-19 virus. In India alone, the virus is responsible for killing more than 143,000 people in just the last 10 months. The spread of virus shows no sign of abating anytime soon. This pandemic has disrupted, even destroyed, many aspects of our lives. It has brought havoc on our economy, caused unprecedented job loss, disrupted social relationships, church services, ministries, and many people have died. It's not uncommon to hear people say that the pandemic has left them feeling drained and exhausted, calling out to God, "How long, O Lord, will this pandemic last?" That cry reminds me of what David said in Psalm 13, when he cried out to the Lord in desperation. May I read this psalm? It's just 6 verses. Psalm 13 goes like this. "How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long must I take counsel in my soul and have sorrow in my heart all the day? How long shall my enemy be exalted over me? Consider and answer me, O Lord my God. Light up my eyes, lest I sleep the sleep of death. Lest my enemy say, I have prevailed over him. Lest my foes rejoice because I am shaken. But I have trusted in your steadfast love. My heart shall rejoice in your salvation. I will sing to the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me." You know, there are many psalms that are constructed like this by the psalmist David. It begins in times of deep distress, and yet it ends on a great note of hope, of singing, of joy. And so I want to just take you quickly through that and make you understand how it is that we also will be able to sing today, even in the midst of the pandemic that we are in. The message of Christmas that comes to me very strongly at this time is that even in the darkness, there is light. In despair, there is hope. In confusion, there is direction. And in the midst of death, we can still experience true life. The birth of the Lord Jesus Christ that we celebrate in this season gives us three assurances. Number one, it assures me that God is sovereign, that He is in control of the universe, of planet Earth, of the nations of the earth, and of your life and mine, my dear friend. That's certainly a very, very comforting thought. When we think of those who are in authority all over the world in this present day, and when we see the decisions that have been made, which are relayed to us in the newspapers and on television and on the internet, that is enough reason for us to be concerned and certainly very anxious. But when I think that my Heavenly Father, who is in ultimate control of everything around me, it calms my heart. The circumstances around the birth of Christ are so unique and miraculous that there is absolutely no way of any of these things happening by chance or coincidence. There can be no doubt that all these events around the birth of Christ were orchestrated by the invisible hand of God. And I'm sure that you can also look back into your life as I can into mine and see this hand, the hand of a shepherd, guiding me, directing me, and sometimes disciplining me so that I can go along the right path. The second assurance I get from the message of Christmas is that God is faithful and that He keeps His promises. You know, more than 350 prophecies about the birth of Christ alone can be found in the Old Testament scriptures. From the moment Adam and Eve fell into sin in the Garden of Eden, right up to 400 years before the birth of Christ through the prophet Malachi, God kept on reminding us salvation is coming. A deliverer is coming. God Himself is coming to save. And when it was time, He kept His promise. So also, my friend, today, God is faithful to keep His promises. He has promised to be with us, even when we are few in number. He has promised to provide for all our needs when we trust in Him and we seek His kingdom. He has promised to forgive us our sins when we come in genuine repentance and confession, to give us a clean heart in the place of our heart of darkness and sin. God is faithful. That's a message of assurance. And thirdly, the message of assurance is that God is interested in my eternal and spiritual well-being. And He is willing to do all that is necessary to give His best so that I can have a good future. Certainly, He cares for your daily needs. He cares for the direction of your life. He cares for the decisions that you need to take from time to time. But much, much more than that, God cares for your eternity. And that's why He sent none other than His own Son into the earth, that He may know poverty, suffering, betrayal, and humiliation. He willingly gave His life on the cross. And right now, He is interceding for His people and suffering along with us during this pandemic. He gave His best for you and for me. He relates so much to what you are going through right now. He is deeply interested, my friend. And so just like King David, when you and I go through such dark days as we are going through now, turn your eyes, turn your mind, turn your heart to reflect on the goodness of God. He who has sustained you and brought you to this point of your life safely is sovereign. He is faithful and He is deeply interested in you. Today you can spread that cheer to those who need it. Just look around you and see how despite your struggles and your suffering, there are many, many others who are struggling even more than you. Reach out to them this Christmas. Even if you may not be their friend or classmate or neighbor, let them find hope this Christmas through you. The story is told of Chippenham George, who worked for the post office in the UK, And his job was to process all the mails that had illegible addresses. And one day just before Christmas, a letter landed on his desk, simply addressed in shaky handwriting, "To God." With no other clue on the envelope, George opened the letter and read, "Dear God, I am a 93-year-old widow living on a state pension. Yesterday, someone stole my purse. It had £100 in it, which was all the money I had in the world, and no pension due until after Christmas. Next week is Christmas, and I had invited two of my friends over for Christmas lunch. Without that money, I have nothing to buy food with. I have no family to turn to, and you are my only hope. God, can you please help me?" Chippenham George was really touched, and being kind-hearted, he put a copy of the letter up on the staff notice board at the main, you know, sorting office where he worked. And that letter touched other postmen, and they all dug into their pockets and, you know, they collected quite a bit of money. They raised £95. And using the officially franked post office envelope, they sent the cash on to the old lady. And for the rest of the day, you know, the workers felt a very warm glow, thinking of the nice thing that they had done. Christmas came and went, and a few days later, another letter simply addressed to God landed in the sorting office. And many of the postmen gathered around while George was opening the letter. It read, "Dear God, how can I ever thank you enough for what you did for me? Because of your generosity, I was able to provide a lovely lunch for my friends. We had a very nice day, and I told my friends of your wonderful gift. In fact, we haven't even got over it. And even Father John, our parish priest, is beside himself with joy. By the way, there was £5 missing. I think it must be those thieving fellows at the post office. Merry Christmas, my friend. God bless you."
Festival lights and sights, a whirlwind of fancy and flight. Bells and jars and candy canes, frosted patterns on window panes. Amidst all the splendor, let us remember those without homes or a fireplace ember.
Mary, did you know that your baby would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you
love came down at Christmas, love all lovely, love divine. Love was born at Christmas, stars and angels gave the sign.
Come, oh come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that mourns in lonely exile, until the sun.
Hi. Millions of homes are filled with the warmth of love and joy on this cold winter's day. Mundane things turn whimsical. Somewhere between believing in a Santa Claus and being a secret Santa, we've all grown up. However, the joy of giving never did fade, for it is in giving that we receive.
The magic of Christmas never ends, and its greatest gifts are family and friends.
Jesus is the king, born for you and me. Come on, ring those bells, everybody say. Jesus, we remember it's your birthday. Come on, ring those bells, light the Christmas tree. Jesus is the king, born for you and me. Come on, ring those bells, everybody say. Jesus, we remember. Jesus, we remember. Jesus, we remember. It's your birthday.
Now that we are in the Yuletide spirit, I'd like to wish you all a happy Christmas and a prosperous and blessed New Year 2021.
See you. Dear staff and students, may the spirit of Christmas infuse your life and that of your family members with hope, positivity and joy during this pandemic. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.